Balbarika. Balbarika, also spelled as Barbarika, is a Hindu god, particularly worshipped in Western India. In the Skanda Purana, Balbarika was the son of Ghatotkacha and Maurvi, daughter of Dithyamur, a Banyu king, though other references state he is a warrior from the south. Balbarika was originally a Yaksh, reborn as a man. He was bound by his principle of always fighting on the weaker side, which led him to stand witness to the battle of Mahabharata without taking part in it. In Nepali culture, Kirta King Yalambar of Nepal is portrayed as Balbarika, while native of Kathmandu Valley portray him as Akash Bhairav. In Rajasthan, Balbarika is worshipped as Khatu Shyamji, and in Gujarat, he is worshipped as Baliyadev, is believed to have been sacrificed before the Mahabharata war to ensure the victory of his grandfathers, the Pandavas. In return for his sacrifice, he was deified by a boon given by Krishna. Balbarika, the Larsen, and his dialogue with Krishna. Balbarika or Khatu Shyamji Baliyadev or Shyam was a grandson of Bhima, second of the Pandav brothers, and the son of Ghatotkacha. Ghatotkacha was the son of Bhima and Hidimbi. Even in his childhood, Balbarika was a very brave warrior. He learned the art of warfare from his mother. The gods, Ashtadev, gave him the three infallible arrows. Hence, Balbarika came to be known as bearer of three arrows. When Balbarika learned that the battle between the Pandavas and the Kauravas had become inevitable, he wanted to witness what was to be the Mahabharata war. He promised his mother that if he felt the urge to participate in the battle, he would join the side which would be losing. He rode to the field on his blue horse equipped with his three arrows and bow. Before the Mahabharata war began, Lord Krishna asked all the warriors how many days it would take to finish the Mahabharata war alone. Bhishma answered that he would take 20 days to finish the war. Dronacharya replied that it would take him 25 days. When Karna was asked, he said he would take 24 days. Arjuna told Krishna it would take 28 days for him to complete the battle by himself. In this manner, Lord Krishna asked each warrior and received an answer. Krishna, disguised as a Brahman, stopped Balbarika to examine his strength. When asked how many days he would take to finish the war alone, Balbarika answered that he could finish it in 1 minute. Krishna then asked Balbarika how he'd finish the great battle with just three arrows. Balbarika replied that a single arrow was enough to destroy all his opponents in the war, and it would then return to his quiver. He stated that the first arrow is used to mark all the things that he wants to destroy. If he uses the second arrow, then the second arrow will mark all the things that he wants to save. On using the third arrow, it will destroy all the things that are not marked and then return to his quiver. In other words, with one arrow he can fix all his targets, and with the other, he can destroy them. Another version of the story goes thus: Balbarika had come to Kurukshetra armed with just three arrows. With one, I can destroy the Pandavas. With the other, the Kauravas. And with the third, Krishna, he said boastfully. Krishna then challenged him to tie all the leaves of the peepal tree under which he was standing, using his arrows. Balbarika Baliyadev accepts the challenge and starts meditating to release his arrow by closing his eyes. As Balbarika starts meditating, Krishna quietly plucks a leaf from the tree and hides it under his foot. When Balbarika releases his first arrow, it marks all the leaves of the tree and finally started hovering around the leg of Krishna. Krishna asks Balbarika why the arrow was hovering over his foot. Barbarika replies that there must be a leaf under his foot, and the arrow was targeting his foot to mark the leaf that is hidden underneath. Barbarika advises Krishna to lift his leg, otherwise the arrow would mark the leaf by piercing Krishna's foot. Krishna then lifts his foot, and the first arrow also marks the hidden leaf. The third arrow then collects all the leaves, including the hidden leaf, and ties them together. By this, Krishna concludes that the arrows are so powerful and infallible that even if Barbarika is unaware of the whereabouts of his targets, his arrows can still navigate and trace his intended targets. The moral of this incident is that, in a real battlefield, if Krishna wants to isolate someone, for example the five Pandav brothers, and hide them elsewhere in order to prevent them from being Barbarika's victim, he would not be successful, as the arrows could trace even the hidden targets and destroy them. So, nobody would be able to escape from these arrows. Thus, Krishna gets a deeper insight into Barbarika's phenomenal power. Krishna then asks the boy whom he would favor in the war. Barbarika reveals that he intends to fight for the side whichever is weak. As the Pandavas have only 7 Akshohini armies compared to the 11 of the Kauravas, he considers that the Pandavas to be relatively the weaker side, and hence wants to support them. But Krishna asks him if he had seriously given a thought about the consequences before giving such a word to his mother about supporting the weaker side. Barbarika assumes that his support to the relatively weaker Pandav side will make them victorious. But Krishna reveals the actual consequences of his word to his mother. Krishna tells that whichever side he supports will end up making the other side weaker due to his power. Nobody will be able to defeat him. Hence, as he will be forced to switch sides to support the other side that has become weaker due to his word to his mother. Thus, in an actual war, he will keep oscillating between two sides, thereby destroying the entire army of both sides, and eventually only he would remain. Subsequently, none of the sides would become victorious and he would be the lone survivor. Hence, Krishna avoids his participation in the war by seeking his head in charity. Act of charity. Krishna then explained to him that before a battle, the head of the bravest Kshatriya needs to be sacrificed in order to worship sanctify the battlefield. Krishna said that he considered Barbarika to be the bravest among Kshatriyas and was hence asking for his head in charity. In fulfillment of his promise and in compliance with Krishna's command, Barbarika gave his head to him in charity. This happened on the 12th day of the Shukla Paksh, bright half of the month of Falgun on Tuesday. Barbarika was a yaksha in his previous birth. Once Lord Brahma and several other devas came to Vaikuntha and complained to Lord Vishnu that the adharma on earth was increasing. It was not possible for them to bear the tortures caused by the wicked people. Hence they came to seek the help of Lord Vishnu to check them. Lord Vishnu told the devas that he will soon be incarnated on earth as a human being and destroy all the evil forces. Then, a yaksha told the devas that he alone is enough to kill all evil elements on the earth, and it was not necessary for Lord Vishnu to descend to earth. This hurt Lord Brahma very much. Lord Brahma cursed this yaksha that whenever the time comes to eliminate all the evil forces on earth, then Lord Vishnu will first kill him. Later, the yaksha takes birth as Barbarika, and Lord Krishna seeks his head in charity as a result of this curse. Since that day, human Barbarika become the Khatu Shyam, the realizer of Lord Krishna by Barbarika given his head, and God Krishna himself manifested in his heart, bearing witness to the war. Before decapitating himself, Barbarika told Krishna of his great desire to view the forthcoming battle and requested him to facilitate the same. Krishna agreed and placed the head on top of a hill overlooking the battlefield. From the hill, the head of Barbarika watched the entire battle. At the end of the battle, the victorious Pandav brothers argued among themselves as to who was responsible for their victory. Krishna suggested that Barbarika's head, which had watched the whole battle, should be allowed to judge. Barbarika's head suggested that it was Krishna alone who was responsible for the victory. Barbarika replies, "All I could see were two things. One, a divine chakra spinning all around the battlefield, killing all those who were not on the side of Dharma. The other was the Draupadi, who has taken her original form of goddess Mahakali, who spread out her tongue on the battlefield and consumed all the sinners as her sacrifice." Listening to this, Pandavas realized that it was Lord Narayana and goddess Parvati, Mahakali, who actually eradicated the Adharma from the world, and the Pandavas were mere instruments. After the war, Barbarika's head was joined with his body, and he left that place for narrating the whole world to maintain peace. His other name is God Kamrunag and is venerated as the preeminent deity in District Mandi in Himachal Pradesh. A pond and a temple are situated in Kamru Hill in Sundarnagar, District Mandi. He witnessed the entire battle of Kurukshetra from the hill, which is now known as Khatu Shyam Temple, located in Khatu village in Sikar district, Rajasthan. An impressive and especially sacred temple of Baliyadev, Barbarik is situated at village Lambha in Ahmedabad district, Gujarat. Observances and festivals. Barbarika is worshipped as Shyam. He is not the supreme personality of Godhead Shri Krishna or any of Krishna's incarnation, but may be considered as the great devotee of Krishna. And since the glories of Krishna's devotee is more than Krishna himself, people worship Khatu Shyam also. Therefore, the flavor of the festivities reflects the playful and vibrant nature of Krishna. The festivals of Krishna Janmashtami, Jhul Jhulni Ekadashi, Holi and Vasant Panchami are celebrated with gusto in the temple. The Falguna Mela detailed below is the principal annual festival. Lakhs of devotees visits the temple every day. Newly married couples come to pay homage and newborn babies are brought to the temple for their mundan, the first hair shaving ceremony. An elaborate aarti is performed at the temple 5 times a day. These are Mandala Aarti, performed in the early morning when the temple is open. Sharingar Aarti, performed at the time of makeup of Baba Shyam. The idol is grandly ornamented for this aarti. Bhog Aarti, performed at noon when Bhog Prasadam is served to the Lord. Sandhya Aarti, performed in the evening at sunset. Two special hymns, the Shri Shyam Aarti and the Shri Shyam Vinti, are chanted on all these occasions. The Shyam Mantra is another litany of the Lord's names that is chanted by devotees. Other particular observances include Shukla Ekadashi and Dwadashi, the 11th and 12th days of the bright half of every month in the Hindu calendar, is of special significance to the temple. This is because Barbarika was born on the 11th day of the bright half of the month of Kartika, and he donated his head, Sheesh, to Krishna on the 12th day of the bright half of the month of Falgun on Tuesday. Darshan on these 2 days is therefore considered auspicious, and devotees come in their thousands every month. The temple remains open throughout the night that falls between these days. Night-long bhajan sessions are organized since devotees traditionally pass the night in singing the praises of the Lord. Devotees organize bhajan programs and invite bhajan singers to sing devotional songs. Bathing in the Shyam Kund, This is the holy pond near the temple from which the idol was retrieved. It is believed that a dip in this pond cures a person of ailments and brings good health. Filled with devotional fervor, people take ritual dips in the Shyam Kund. They believe that this will relieve them of diseases and contagion. Bathing during the annual Falguna Mela festival is deemed specially salutary. Nishan Yatra. It is believed that your wishes are granted if you offer a Nishan at the temple. A Nishan is a triangular flag of a particular size, made of cloth, which is hoisted on a bamboo stick. It is carried in one's hands while covering the route from the town of Ringas to Khatu, 17 kilometers, on bare foot. Nishans are offered in millions during the Falguna Mela. Falguna Mela, the most important festival associated with the temple is the Falguna Mela, which occurs just 8 to 9 days before the festival of Holi. Barbarika's head appeared on Falguna Shuddha Ekadshi, the 11th day of the bright half of the Hindu month of Falguna. Therefore, the fair is held from the 9th to the 12th of that month. The fair has now been extended to nearly 12 to 15 days of the bright half of the Falguna month. Khatu Shyamji Rath Idol during Pad Yatra from Kota to Khatu Shyamji in 2008. On this holy occasion, pilgrims all over the country come here on foot with Nishans, holy mark flags, in their hands. People enjoy their holy journey by singing Shyam Bhajans and playing various musical instruments. They enjoy the journey by playing Holi with Gulal. Many Shyam Bhaktas supply food to pedestrians in the shade of tents. They encourage also them to complete their journey with full enthusiasm. They enjoy this occasion as the marriage of Khatu Shyamji. People enjoy the Mela by purchasing various things. On Dwadashi, is equal to 12th day of a month, Bhog is being prepared as Babas, Prasadi of Kheer Churama. Special arrangements for security are made to control the crowd. Around 500,000 people visit in 3 days of this holy Mela in this small village. To briefly see Baba Shyam's idol, very tight security is made with the help of bamboo fence around 2 kilometers